Well, I wanted to show you an interesting sequence of numbers.
Go on.
So here we go. I'm going to start here. Well, you might notice that I'm missing out a couple here and there. 39, 30, 33, 34, and so on. Most of them are here, but if you look carefully, you'll see that here we're missing 4 and 5, and down here we should be missing 13 and 14, 23 and 22, 31 and 32. Well, there's a supposition or a conjecture that all of these numbers can be written as a sum of 3 cubes of integers. It's probably best done by example. If I take this number here, for example, 29, it means that I can write this as a sum of 3 cubes of integers, and in this case it can be written as 3 cubed plus 1 cubed, so 3 cubed is 27, plus 1 cubed is 28, plus 1 cubed is 29. So it's thought that all of the other integers have a similar representation. And I should point out that you are allowed to represent your number by negative numbers as well. So you're allowed to take sums of 3 cubes in which one of the, or more of the integers, is a negative number. What's quite striking is that for some of the numbers, even on this very list, it's actually surprisingly difficult to write down the solution to the problem. To illustrate what I mean, we just have to go a little bit along the line here to this number 30, and I'm going to need a little bit more space, but maybe you would care to hazard a guess as to what the solution to this problem is.
Is it an easy one? Is it a hard one?
It's a hard one. I should say that this was only discovered in 1999. It was discovered by computer. It's actually quite surprising, I think. So, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, let's go. I have had to write this down, but let's go. 2220422932 all cubed plus minus 2128.
That was a negative number.
This is the negative number, and there's one more negative number here. Minus 283,059,956 all cubed.
That's amazing.
Yes, it's quite striking, I think.
29 was so simple and 30 was so difficult.
That's right. So as you carry on up the list, you'll find this phenomena continuing. So some occasions where you'll be able to find very small solutions, and then just next door to it, there'll be a number cropping up which seems to have enormously large solutions.
Are there many other unsolved ones? Or?
Sadly, yes. I'm going to come back to these ones. But the next eligible one is this number 33. And in fact, we still don't know an answer to that one. So we've not yet been able to find any integers which, when you sum their cubes, you get 33. Search has been pretty thorough. So far they've gone up to, I think they've gone up to the numbers of size 10 to the 14. So that's one with 14 zeros after it. Within that range, there are no solutions.
The question people are going to have then is, I mean, maybe this number doesn't belong on the list. Why is the number on the list if we haven't got a solution?
That's a very good question. And there have been some attempts to prove that this number isn't on the list, but those attempts have failed. Therefore it is, and it's perfectly allowable that the first solution might just be ginormous.
But there are numbers that are off the list.
There are numbers that are off the list. Let me tell you about the numbers off the list. So I'll just write them down again. So we had 4, 5, 13, 14, 22, 23, 31, 32. So you might wonder what those numbers have in common.
What have they done wrong?
Well, their great crime is that they can all be written as 9 times an integer, so 9 times an integer k, plus 4, or 9 times an integer k plus 5. So for example, 4 is clearly 9 times 0 plus 4. And for example, 31 here is 9 times 3, which is 27, plus 4. So they all meet this criteria. And indeed, if you write down any number which is of this shape, 9 times k plus 4 or 9 times k plus 5, it will never be written as a sum of 3 cubes. And that's something that we can actually prove. I mean, what's going on here? We're looking at equations of this shape. So for example, a cubed plus b cubed plus c cubed equal to, so for example, 33. So this is an example of what's called a Diaphantine equation. And this is a very central topic in number theory. It's been studied, I would say, for lots of years. So they're named after someone called Diophantus, who lived in about 250 AD, a Greek. But thinking about problems like this goes back even further, some 4,000 years to the Babylonians. But the question is, if you have a polynomial equation like this, can you, first of all, decide whether it has solutions in integers? That's what we're trying to do in this special case. If it does have solutions, you could even ask, how many are there? Are there infinitely many, or just, you know, just a handful? And if there are infinitely many, can you describe their frequency in some sense? And this is a sort of area of research that I'm actively engaged with. So we do not have a proof that this has solutions in integers. It is conjectured that this has solutions in integers. All that we can hope to do at the moment is just use a computer and try and find them.
This is not something that can ever be proven by brute force, because there's always another number, isn't there?
Absolutely, yes. Absolutely. So I just wanted to go back to the first number on the list that we had up here, actually, number one. You know, we're not going to have to spend too much time scratching our heads to come up with a solution to this one, right? We could take, you want to have a guess?
Yep, one cubed, zero cubed, zero cubed.
Okay, so that was easy. So there's at least one solution, and you might ask, you know, are there others? I'm going to write another solution. We can write one as 10 cubed plus 9 cubed minus 12 cubed. So people that have seen your taxicab video might get a bit excited about that particular one, but let's not go into that here.
All right. So you've got, so there are two ways to do this.
Two ways to do this. And in fact, there are infinitely many ways to do this in this particular case. And it's not hard to write down what's called a parametric solution. So I'm writing one as 1 plus 9 m cubed, all cubed, plus 9 m⁴, all cubed, plus minus 9 m⁴ minus 3 m, all cubed. And the point of this is that this is valid for any m. Yes, so in the first case, if I put in m equal to 0, I get 1, 0, 0. If I put m equal to 1, I get 10, 9, and minus 12. But you could put anything in, and you'd just get tons and tons of solutions. So yeah, in the list that I started with, one is a bit special in that, in fact, there's this parametric family of solutions, and there are infinitely many different ways of writing one as a sum of three cubes. There are relatively few examples where we actually have these parametric solutions. And if we go back to one of the examples we saw before, so for example, this number 30, it's suspected that there are not parametric solutions. Although, in fact, it is suspected that there are infinitely many solutions, but they just get big very, very quickly. And so as you measure their density, there are very few solutions overall. The whole point about a parametric solution is that there is a formula for the solutions. You can just plug in numbers and it'll give you some answers. That's not the case for these other examples, or it's suspected to not be the case for these other examples. You have to work quite hard to find them.
29. It is 12 cubed plus 1 cubed.
Or you can write it as 10 cubed plus 9 cubed equals 1729.